The Coming Wave by Mustafa Suleyman. We are approaching a threshold in human history where everything is about to change and none of us are prepared. Hi, and welcome to the Book Lab. I'm Björn, and this is the place where we bring you the best book recommendations when it comes to philosophy, psychology, human nature, and human potential every week. So make sure to subscribe. Today, we're going to talk about The Coming Wave by Mustafa Suleyman. I'm going to share my thoughts on the book, my favorite takeaways, give you a taste of what this book is about, and also share a personal story of how AI impacted my own life. In the near future, our lives will be deeply intertwined with AI. Mustafa Suleyman, a co-founder of the groundbreaking AI company DeepMind, which is now under Google's umbrella, he has been at the forefront of AI developments for a long time. He believes that the next decade will be shaped by the developments of exponential technologies. In his latest book, The Coming Wave, Suleyman discusses the potential for vast prosperity for all using these advanced technologies, but he also warns for the risk they pose to the fundamental structures of global governance. With many governments seemingly oblivious to the looming threat, we are presented with a dilemma. On the one hand, we see a potential for a lot of unforeseen negative consequences due to technology. And on the other hand, if we try to control it too much, we will end up in a society of constant monitoring of each and every one of us. How can we navigate the narrow road in front of us and not fall off the cliff? AI is a big deal because it's a general purpose technology, and there hasn't been that many general purpose technologies invented through the human lifespan, only about 24 or so. Some examples of such technologies are farming, the factory system, the processing of materials such as iron and bronze, the printing press, and of course the internet. Quote, "For the first time, core components of our technological ecosystem directly address two fundamental properties of our world, intelligence and life." What he talks about here is AI and synthetic biology. Technology is going to rival and eventually surpass our intelligence, and it's going to engineer life. We have entered a new phase of humanity. In the book, Mustafa Suleyman argues for containment of technology, but it's a tricky question. What does containment even mean? It means to be able to stop, slow down, or even forbid certain technologies. Basically, we need to be able to contain technology that we deem as dangerous. The technologies discussed in this book have huge upsides if everything goes right. It can solve world hunger, resource problems, global warming, some of the biggest issues that humanity is facing. But the same technologies have the power to mess things up really bad. Take quantum computing, for instance. The instant it's available, all cybersecurity efforts that we've ever come up with are compromised within the second. Synthetic biology and altering human DNA could introduce a new species of humans. Other biological experiments could leak from labs and cause the next big pandemic and massive death. It has already happened and it will happen again. And imagine autonomous weaponized drones and how it will change the dynamics of warfare. The technologies that I talk about here are not far in the future. They are just around the corner or they're already here. As the demand for these technologies goes up, prices go down, and the barrier of entry also goes down, which means a democratization of all these possibly dangerous technologies, which could fall into the hands of bad actors. But the biggest problem with containing technologies is like this, that is that we have tried before and we have barely succeeded, often failed. Quote, "The worrying truth about this fearsome technology is that humanity has tried to say no, but only partially succeeded. The fact is that the only successful containment of technology has been nuclear weapons, and there we just barely succeeded. And to be honest, creating a nuclear bomb is not something that an individual could just do, or even a group of people, because it demands very rare and highly valuable materials. You need a lot of special expertise to do it. In the case of synthetic biology and AI, on the other hand, people can have it as a hobby project that they do in their basement, and the outcome could still be world-changing and have a huge impact on things. Containment has historically been very hard, and there is more hurdles on the way, and some of those are the incentives. technologists, they want to be the first at developing a new technology because they have egos, right? And there's financial incentives for coming up with new technologies. There's also investment from a state side. Being ahead in the technological race gives a nation an edge. So there's several incentives for pushing technology forward in all manners possible. Technology democratizes power, but it also democratizes risk. Today, no matter how rich you are, you can't buy a better smartphone than what is already available to billions of people. And this is remarkable. Never in history has so advanced technology been available so widely throughout society. The internet allowed you to get access to information. The common wave will allow you to take action in the world. And that's where the real power lies. Not only will you be able to access the best man speech on the internet and take inspiration from it, it will be written for you and customized for you by AI. You and almost everyone else will have access to the best legal advice, the best negotiator, the best business strategists, the best dietist, the best everything thanks to AI. And this is a huge societal change. This is a huge democratization of power, but it's also a democratization of the risks that comes with power. Let's talk about AI and the job market. But before we do that, I just wanted to say that if you enjoy the content, then like and subscribe to the channel. I put out video reviews and book recommendations every week, and every month I do a summary of the best new books that come out. This was one of the new releases from October, I think. So if you want those videos to pop up in your feed, then you just like this video and it will show up as soon as I publish something. Technology has displaced labor before, but those jobs were then replaced by new ones. But now the question is slightly different. What says that AI couldn't do the new jobs as well? Compared to other job eliminating technologies, AI has general purpose use. They are omni-use. Weavers were replaced by textile machines. Suddenly, a child could produce the same amount of work as 3.5 workers. And the same thing happened with agricultural machines. Elevator operators were replaced by buttons. These replacements of humans with machines has happened throughout history, but it has happened in a pace that society can handle. AI changes all of that. Take my own job, for instance. I work as a video game developer, and most of the disciplines within video game development is impacted by AI in one way or another. Concept artists are being replaced by generative AI. Coders are working together with AIs to get their code out faster. Animation tasks are being automated. 3D artists such as myself, we see the rise of text to 3D model where you can just enter a prompt to create a model that you can place in the game world. We have started to use AI voice actors instead of real actors for most of the production of the game because it's faster and it's less work than to hire people, and it's good enough so that we only need to hire professional voice actors towards the tail end of the production. All in all, we are able to do much more, but with less people. AI and robotics will revolutionize work, and it will be at the pace that society will have a hard time keeping up with. So what did I think about the book? It covers all these topics that I talked about, so I just wanted to give you a little bit of a taste of it. It's a paradoxical book because it tries to be hopeful, but it fails a little bit. I felt hopeless when I read this book. It's like this wave of technology that's coming at us, and I'm following this very closely, is just overwhelming. There is no scenario where this will not have some kind of bad output together with some good ones, right? Mustafa Suleyman is a proponent of containment, but he also describes how hard it would be to pull off. And it's only towards the tail end of the book that we get some really practical advice for at least how we can start looking into the containment problem. What I thought would be impossible throughout this book actually turned into hope towards the end, which was really good. He has some really good points. I can't go right into them in this one because then this video would be too long. But he managed to end on a positive note. And I think we have a lot of challenges ahead of us. And if you're interested in AI, I've talked a lot about this book, Scary Smart. I praised it a lot as a great beginner's book about AI. And I still think it is. It's probably a bit more accessible than this one. But This book was trumped by this one. This is the best book on AI that I read the last 2 years, and I tried to read a few of them at least. I think it's an absolutely must read if you want to prepare yourself for the coming wave, create a strategy forward, and know what all these issues are about. What fascinated me about this book was the idea of synthetic biology, which I knew less about than the AI specifically. And that is just a crazy, crazy field of technology that you need to read up on. I truly recommend this book. It's really good. Next week will be a slightly different video where I go through my upcoming reading list, presenting the books that has me excited, I want to read in the future. And that might be a place where you can find some really good books to pick up for the remaining months of the year. The next review that will be up is Scarcity Brain by Michael Eastern. I loved The Comfort Crisis. I've recommended it so many times on this channel. I'm reading his follow-up book now, and that will be my next review that I post on the site. Happy reading, everyone. Thanks for listening, and I love you. See you next week.